How's it going, everybody? My name is Grofana, and welcome to Let's Play Oblivion Part 29. We are still doing the Mage's Guild. We are going to finish up the recommendations and move on in this episode, hopefully, if everything goes according to plan. Really quickly, before I start this episode off, I just wanted to say, if you guys didn't check out my 30,000 subscribers video, please do that. If you have no interest in the Binding of Isaac whatsoever, believe me, I understand. I didn't either until I bought it, and then I got quickly addicted to it. I think you guys will find it's pretty interesting. I'll put a link on the screen right now, and go and check that out if you want to. Anyways, we're gonna get started. So, let's take a look at our quest journal here. Bravo recommendation. Kudai has given me several more scrolls and asked me to get the staff back. I need to find Soros Irenim in the Imperial City, and if you remember, we are trying to get back a stolen staff for our Bravo recommendation. And this is his house right here, so hopefully we'll be able to get the staff back. Is that you? Yes, it is. This seems to be Soros. I need to inquire about the mage's staff.
Yes, I have the staff Baron sold me. I'm afraid I'm not willing to part with it. I paid good money for it, after all. You understand, of course.
Oh, don't do me like that. So as you can see here, the dialogue option is still highlighted, which means all we have to do is charm this guy into giving him giving us the staff. Okay, so let's put our charm spell that we get for free for being an Imperial. Let's see if that'll do the trick. It probably won't.
As much.
Yeah, and so we'll also go into persuade and hit Y a couple times, and that should.
Look, I can't just give it to you. I paid good money for it, after all. I'll tell you what. You give me at least a portion of what I paid for it, say 200 gold, and I'll give you the staff. That's a good deal, right? I wouldn't offer it to anyone else, just you. So, what do you say?
So I would imagine that if you didn't have 200 gold, which, I mean, come on, you should have 200 gold, and we're pretty good on money right now, so that's no problem. I would imagine you'd be able to either charm this guy even higher, maybe if you get him to like 100 or something, he'll give it to you, or you can probably pickpocket it, or if he doesn't have it on his person, you can probably find it in his house somewhere. Anyways, I'm just going to say it's a deal, because that's the easy way.
I'll just take the money from you then. And here's your staff. Now, since our business is concluded, you must excuse me. Good day.
Good day to you, friend. Thank you for getting me my Bravo recommendation. And to finish that off, all we have to do is go back to Bravo. So let's do it. Alright, here we are back in Bravo. The weather is absolutely atrocious, as you can see. Adding to the already disgusting aesthetics of Bravo, as I keep mentioning every time we come back. But it's not a big deal. We're going to head on over to the Mage's Guild, which, if you remember, is right over here. How in the world did we take falling damage from that? I have no idea. Luckily for us, the Mage's Guild is open 24/7, so we don't have to wait. And let's go talk to Kudai and finish up this quest. Looks like she's upstairs in the second floor. Looks like she's upstairs in the third floor. There you are. Don't go to sleep. Don't you go to sleep.
Do you have the Mage's staff, associate?
I do, actually.
Ah, wonderful. I shall be most pleased to return this to its rightful owner. Thank you. You needn't tell me the details of what was involved in getting it. It's perhaps better that I know nothing about it. Your actions for the guild more than merit a recommendation. I shall send it to the university promptly. And to thank you more personally, I shall teach you this spell. You may find it useful in certain circumstances.
And what spell is that? Captivate. So that's going to be a charm spell. Chances are it's not going to be...
And I think you're the only one that I can turn to.
Yeah, she's going to give us a side quest, but we are just going to focus on the Mage's Guild for the time being. We are going to complete that side quest eventually, and that's actually a pretty interesting and unique side quest, so I'm definitely going to be doing that. Where are we going through here? So as I was saying, the spell that she just taught us is probably going to be a much lesser potent charm spell than the one we already have as a greater power. The offset being, of course, is that we can use it whenever we want, as long as we have enough magicka. Let's take a look at it really quickly, though, just to see what it does. Captivate, where are you? There you are. Charm 10 points for 10 seconds on touch, as opposed to charm 30 points for 30 seconds on target. So yeah, that's obviously a much better skill. Or spell. Anyways, we need to keep doing these recommendations. I think we only have one more. We've done Bruma, we've done Coral, even though it says we haven't. We've done Shadenhall. We have not done Leowyn, which is going to be all the way down here. I think this might be the last one. Let's go find out. Alrighty, here we are in Leowyn. which is another town that I'm not particularly fond of the aesthetics. But that's no big deal. I do like the houses, though. Like, each house is a ginormous house, or each structure is huge, and it's got, like, either a red or a yellow color on it. Okay, so I guess this is the Mage's Guild. Yes, it is. We'll head on inside. See what we have to do for the recommendation. Alright, who's in charge around here? Oh, I hate when we're running around when it's, like, not business hours. As you can see, it's 4:21 a.m. So I'm gonna go ahead and blaze it up because it's 4:20. No, just kidding. We're gonna wait. 12 would be 4, 3, 2, 1. Whoops, I didn't press A. And now the person in charge should be walking around the halls. Yes, indeed. Is it this old woman over here?
You seek wisdom from me, child? Ah, no. You seek words. Words are.
Actually, I seek... What are you... Oh, was this a side quest? Okay, she's offering us a side quest, so I guess that's not the person. Who is the person? Is it this guy right here?
What?
Recommendation?
Oh, boy. Good luck getting that. DeGale's the only one who can write one. If she can remember who she is today, that is.
Huh, that's not good. So the person that was offering us that side quest is the one that we need to get a recommendation from. Also, this guy is very weird looking, isn't he? Okay, let's see if we can get a recommendation from DeGale.
Have you reconsidered, child? Will you aid me?
Well, I guess I have to because there's no other dialogue option. Hopefully this will get us our recommendation as well. I'm not sure. I think it does, but I forget. Yes, I'll help.
Then seek Agata, child. She will see the path and set you on it. I must rest.
Okay, can we inquire about a recommendation? No, we cannot. Let's see that quest, though. Leywin recommendation, so it is a recommendation quest. Okay, very good. I need to find an amulet so that DeGale will send me a recommendation. Send a recommendation to the Arcane University for me. Agata may know more. Where is this Agata? There you are.
Yes? Is there something I can help you with, associate?
There is, actually. Recommendation.
I take it you've spoken to DeGale. Then you know she is not well. She has visions, for lack of a better term. While they used to be helpful at times, they have lately become problematic. There was an amulet, a family heirloom that she wore to suppress and sometimes focus the visions. She's lost the amulet, and so has lost control.
Okay, visions?
At times, they served her well. She gained something of a reputation in the guild and was highly valued by the council. As she aged, the visions became less coherent. Rather than cast her aside, the council gave her a position here. Some resent her and wish she'd disappear. I do not. I am proud to help her with her daily tasks.
Aren't you a great person? Okay, how about Seer Stone?
I'm surprised she discussed it with you. She wanted to keep it from the others. I should speak to her about that. Yes, her Seer Stone is missing. It's the one thing that has kept her visions at bay. And without it, they're nearly crippling. She can't function. We haven't yet spoken to the others, for fear they would be less than accepting of her situation. Perhaps it is time, though. I will continue to tend to DeGale. Can you speak with the other mages and find out if any of them had seen the stone?
Okay, fair enough. Let's go talk to this really weird-looking guy first.
What?
Seer Stone.
Well, well. Word is finally spreading, is it? They won't be able to keep up this facade much longer. Yeah, I know all about it. I overheard Agata and DeGale talking. And you know what? I'm glad it's gone. Why should we be forced to work under someone who's only kept sane by a magical trinket? Haven't we sacrificed enough already? She shouldn't even be here anymore. Hell, the only reason her father ever fit in anywhere is because he kept a low profile. And look what it got him. Years of service to the Empire, and not even a tombstone over his head. Poof! At least he was able to maintain the illusion of sanity. I know. I get way too fired up over this. It just annoys me that she's in charge of the guild when she's clearly not fit, that's all.
Thank you, but that did not answer my question at all about where the location of the Seer Stone is. Kalthar seemed to know a great deal about the missing amulet. I should tell Agata what he has told me. Okay.
Yes?
Seer Stone.
So Kalthar overheard us, did he? That explains why he's been so cranky lately. But we never said anything about DeGale's father. How would he know anything about that? If there's some sort of connection between the Seer's Stone and DeGale's father, I don't know about it. Maybe if you ask her, it will jog her memory. In the meantime, I'll keep an eye on Kalthar.
Well, that's going to be easy for you, considering he's right across from you. This is great that we have all three of these people that are integral to this quest right in the same room. Okay, so let's ask her about her father.
Is it more than me, child? It is as I have seen. I know what you would ask. You would bring light to that which is in darkness, bring silence to the voices so loud. I know where you must go. Blood ran blue and dragons flew high. Under broken towers and broken bodies it now lies, waiting to be found. What was my sire's must be mine if you would have the words you seek. You must go and find his stone.
Okay, so we've finally been sent on a legit quest to go retrieve this Seer's Stone. And it shouldn't be too hard. From what I remember, it's probably going to be located in a cave. I need to find the fort at which DeGale's father was stationed. It should be somewhere near Leowyn. That's very vague, isn't it? But I guess we have a map marker directly to the place. That's going to be Fort Blueblood, and I guess we're going to head over to Bogwater, where we killed that poor Argonian agent, and we'll head on over. Alright, so here we are at Bogwater. There's the campfire that belonged to the Argonian that is now dead somewhere around here. I don't want to look for him. Anyways, we're going to hop on Shadowmere and head over, and I'll see you guys in a second. Alright, so here we are at Fort Blue Blood. Hopefully there won't be too many enemies that we have to dispatch on the outside, because I'm sure there are going to be some on the inside. I hear the combat music already. Shadowmere can hopefully take care of them. We're just going to head on inside unless we can find the enemies, which I'm not seeing. Where are you taking me, green quest marker? I've arrived at Fort Blueblood. DeGale's father should be buried inside. Okay. And there's the entrance. Let's enter sneak and enter the door. Alrighty, combat music is still playing, but we are in sneak mode. I thought that was a pull chain over there for a second, but this is not Skyrim, is it? Uh-oh. Why are we being detected so easily? That's weird. Who is this person? Marauder. Okay, so I guess they're just in here to try and find some loot. Unfortunately for her, however, she's only going to find swift death in the form of a whole bunch of arrows. Alright. So let's take that arrow back. Let's go back into sneak. Let's loot her body, get my arrows back that I shot into her, and then I guess we can't head over that way because it's just a gate. Oh my god, why am I getting detected so easily? That's a question I guess we're never going to find out throughout this entire series, but it is pretty freaking annoying because I swear, every other playthrough, like, I'm never, ever, ever detected. Dwarven arrows are good, though. Iron arrows good. Iron bow. What bow are we using right now? Dremora light bow. Yeah, that's definitely not better. But it's good to have a backup bow. Then again, yeah, I'm gonna take it. Okay. Alright, let's go back into sneak. I mean, we're wearing the, full dark, like the listener robes and everything, the Black Hand hood and the Black Hand robe, and that means that we have like the lowest sounding boots, or the softest sounding boots. So I don't know why I'm getting detected so easily, and our sneak is decent as well. It's weird. Anyways, let's dispatch these guys. This orc has a nice dwarven longsword, very cool. It's not gonna matter though. This person has just a normal steel longsword, so I guess they're not as cool as the friend. Die. Okay. We got some steel arrows, and you have some steel arrows as well. That all belong to me. As you can see, because we're leveling up, these people are starting to get better equipment, and they're not your run-of-the-mill bandit with leather armor. Yeah, they're starting to get into higher tiered levels, that being a marauder. Anyways, we're gonna head deeper into this cave, hopefully find a door soon that will lead us to... detected, like, immediately. Okay. Might as well just run here, guns blazing, I guess. Are you gonna attack me? Or you're a conjurer? Nice shot, you almost killed your friend there, buddy. Had to eat my words immediately, though, because then he got a perfect hit on me. Don't you heal yourself. There's a lot of orcs in here. All these orcs with long swords. Oh, I did not know that was a drop. Alright. And... okay. And goodbye. Alright. Repair hammer, that's cool. I wonder if that's like a drop that drops more significantly on orcs rather than other races, since orcs are known for their metalworking. Would make sense. Jump over here. Open this chest, get some gold. Okay, we'll head down here. Which should be the next section of the dungeon, I would assume. Fort Blue Blood Halls. Alright. Green quest marker. Oh, God. See, immediately. Like, I don't even have a chance. I don't get it. I don't get it at all. Sound like a broken record, probably, in all of these Let's Plays, but I don't get why I'm getting detected every single second. But it's just seriously, it's like it's never happened. Are we out of arrows? It would appear so. But I know we have a ton of different arrows, so we're fine. Okay. Another one bites. Dust. And loot all those arrows back, and we'll head down here.
Your presence here will not be tolerated.
Alright. There are a ton of people to fight in this fort, that's for sure. All those dagger swings didn't get that guy anything. And die. Marksman skill increase, thank you. Should probably be healing up to not only heal us back to full health, but also increase our restoration, which I haven't been doing as much as I usually do. And obvious trap is obvious. Gonna go ahead and step on it, just because I want to see the animation happen. And another wooden door. Uh-oh. It's an archer battle. Much like Skyrim, all you gotta do really is strafe left and right while you fire in a straight shot. Ooh, got hit. Kinda knew I would there, though. Okay, we're gonna go into a sneak here, though, and hit this guy from afar. Kind of anticipated he was gonna move, considering they keep doing that as I play more into this Let's Play. Alright, can you stop moving for no reason, please? So I can shoot you and deal sneak damage bonuses? Like that. Took down almost all of his health. Alright, can't jump while we have this drawn, so we'll just let him run at us. All helter skelter. Get those arrows, get the Fort Blue Blood key, so I guess that's like the boss of this room. And one more guy, okay. This guy's gonna get the fireball treatment. Alright. I'm sensing the thing that we are looking for is near, probably right behind these doors that we opened with that key that we got from the orc. There's a dead body that we didn't do, or we didn't kill. I guess you can't kill a dead body, but you guys know what I mean. And what in the hell is that? That is a... what's it called? I forget. Will-o'-the-wisp. Yeah. Can be annoying to hit, especially when they teleport all around the room and deal significant damage. Alright. Let me hit you, please. I don't know how an arrow is supposed to do damage to a floating... orb. But it's beyond me to question the Elder Scrolls. Okay. You need to take more damage than you were currently taking, please. Don't have any magic at a heal, so we kind of need to take care of this thing faster than we're doing right now. Okay, wow, I'm just being terrible right now. Please die. This is very tedious and boring. Die. Thank you. Alright, we'll take that. Did I take it? I don't even know. What do these guys drop? Glow dust, that's right. Okay, so we'll take that. We also have another body here. So I guess the will-o'-the-wisp killed these guys. A bone with only one singular bone, or a coffin with only one singular bone, I mean, and a whole bunch of coffins, so I guess we need to find the good one, and that's going to be this one, Manduin's Coffin, which is going to have Manduin's amulet. I would assume that's what we need to find. I found the amulet DeGale needed. I should return it to her immediately. Hopefully we won't get betrayed by anyone. Actually, we're going to open this chest really quickly by spamming the X button. Oh, 27 gold. What an insignificant reward. Okay. Like I said, hopefully we won't get betrayed by anyone. Oh!
Just stop right there, all right? I can't let you leave with that amulet. I need it right now.
Why do you want the amulet?
I took the other one, and that should have been enough. I shouldn't have to go through all this just to get rid of her. It's not even as if I was going to keep it forever. I was going to give it back to her once I'd gotten what I wanted. That's not so wrong, is it? Once she helped me advance out of that place and step down, then she could have it back. Why did you have to get in the way? Why are you trying to ruin everything?
Well, I was going to tell him to calm down, but it looks like he's going immediately aggro. And that's totally fine, because I don't think this guy's going to be much of a... Ah! As he zaps me. Okay, let's equip. I'm feeling Sufferthorn right now. Let's do it. Oh, you summoned a skeleton? You think that's going to help you, buddy? Skeletons don't do shit in this game. Uh-oh. As I'm taking copious amounts of damage while taunting this guy that may kill me. But no, of course he didn't. I've defeated Kalthar, who was attempting to manipulate DeGale. I need to give her this information. Immediately, there goes the skeleton along with him. What do you got? A Leshrood song and Galarian the Mystic, Kalthar's key, and some gold. Let's go ahead and head over to those books and just see if they're skill books. No, and what was the other one? A song, a Leshrood song, which is not as well. Alright guys, I'm going to head out of this dungeon and head back to Braavel, or Leowyn, and I'll see you guys there. Alright, here we are back in the Leowyn Mage's Guild. We're going to go ahead and talk to DeGale.
Nothing has changed, child. The voices still cry out, and I am unable to hear. If they can be sealed away, our work may begin.
Seer's Stone.
Found it, have you? Silenced the hands that betrayed and took what was mine? Then let me have the stone so that the voices can be shut out.
Okay, there you go.
Ah, child, I thank you for helping me. With the voices quieted for now, the words you seek have come to me. You shall have my recommendation. Though I must warn you, I've seen things in your future. Things which may be, and things which will be. It will be up to you to decide the fate of many. Life and death are strange things, easily manipulated, and both will be altered by your hands.
Oh, lady, you have no idea how much I have already altered life and death. I've received recommendations from all of the local guild halls in Cyrodiil. I must now travel to the Arcane University and speak with Raminus Polis. So, I already know what the title of this Let's Play is going to be, and that's going to be Moving On Up, because, ladies and gentlemen, we are moving on up in the Mage's Guild, at least. So, let's go ahead and go to the Arcane University. We're hitting the big time, folks. Alright, we've seen this building before. This is the Arcane University, which now, because we've gotten recommendations from all the local guild halls, we shall be able to access. I don't think we can go through here just yet. No, we have to go inside and talk to Raminus Polis, and I don't think he's going to be there, so we need to wait. Again, it's 4 a.m. Why is it always 4 a.m.? We're going to wait 12, which would be 4 p.m. 3, 2, 1, and then 12 p.m. would be good. So, yeah. Yeah, so our waiting got interrupted, and that's because there is a Mythic Dawn. Why? Oh, there's two Mythic Dawns. So I think this guy can handle himself, but we might as well help him out.
Paradise awaits me.
Does it, though? Does Paradise await you? How can you be sure? And there goes Sufferthorn. It just broke in our hands. That's not good. So let's go ahead and equip our Dremorlite bow again. Okay. Loot these people. So Marguerite Deal is also a Mythic Dawn supporter. And also, Sirbjorn is as well. And now we need to wait again about 6 hours. Okay. Now Raminus Polis should be inside the lobby, which it looks like he is. And there he is.
Hello, associate. It seems you've obtained the final recommendation you required.
Yes, recommendation.
I have received recommendations from all the local guild halls in Cyrodiil. You've done well for yourself. You may now enter the university.
Sweet.
As a full-fledged member of the Mage's Guild, I now also promote you to the rank of apprentice and grant you the robe of the apprentice. Take a moment and try it on. Then we shall speak of what comes next for you.
Okay, I can already tell you I'm not going to be wearing it, but let's take a look at it nevertheless. Where are you, Robe of the Apprentice? There you are. Ugly, ugly, olive green. That's not even olive green, is it? That's like a darker shade. Which does fortify willpower 6 points on self. It's almost completely useless for what we have going for us right now, so I'm going to go ahead and unequip that. But anyways.
We come to the real work at last. You have, no doubt, seen some of the worst the guild has to offer. As much as we try to hold mages to a higher standard, they are only human. What I hope you will now see is that while the Guild can be disjointed and misused, it can also achieve some wonderful things. Now you have an opportunity to engage in more meaningful tasks and continue with your advancement through the Guild.
Okay, advancement.
You do not yet qualify for further advancement in the Guild.
Kind of figured that. Let's go ahead with tasks then.
Before you can begin work for the Guild, you'll need to do something for yourself. Every mage carries a staff. It is crafted and enchanted by the Guild and is a symbol of status. You need such a staff.
Okay, mage's staff.
The wood used for staves comes from a grove to the northeast of the Imperial City, near Wellspring Cave. Several mages tend to the grove and should be able to assist you. Speak with either Zarasha or Illette when you arrive, and choose wisely.
Okay, so this is actually a really interesting... Well, first off, I want to just let you guys know that when you see this little icon on the bottom left, since a lot of you have been saying that you're playing this game along with me, some of you may be new to the game, when you see this on the bottom left, that means you can buy spells from a certain person, and if you are a mage character, this is very helpful for increasing your spell repertoire. As you can see here, you can buy a whole bunch of stuff. Most of it is completely useless for me because I don't have enough magicka, which is the left number, as you can see there, signified by that lightning bolt. The right number is the amount of money it's going to cost to buy it. But yeah, lots of powerful spells you can buy from different people. Raminus Polis is a great guy to buy spells from. Okay, so as Raminus said, this is the time where the Mage's Guild starts getting really interesting. The recommendations were sort of just like a little taste of what you're going to have to do in the Mage's Guild. Now we need to go to the Wellspring Cave, and the purpose of that is to get some wood so that we will be able to craft our own mage's staff. And this is actually a pretty interesting quest because you can pick all these different options that are going to change how the staff comes out, and you can basically fine-tune it to what you would usually do. Unfortunately, it's going to be pretty useless for me considering I don't use a lot of magic. However, it is nice to keep in your house or something as like a memorabilia type deal. Anyways, this is going to be the end of this episode because this starts a whole new quest, it's not going to be as simple as you guys think it may be, and it's going to be a whole big deal, and so we will start that next time, and we're going to start getting into the meat of the Mage's Guild, and that's what I really like about it. So thanks for watching. My name's Grovana, and have a great day. Bye. Hey everybody, I hope you enjoyed watching that video. If you did, please consider leaving a like. Also, if you'd like to subscribe and or watch a video that's probably going to be related to the one that you just watched, you can click the annotations on the screen. Finally, if you want to help me grow my channel, you can also share this video on Facebook and Twitter by clicking share below the video. Regardless, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys later.